When we are using our shortest time to completion or our shortest job first algorithms, we have to care about the length of the next CPU burst. But we can't predict the future. We can try to estimate what that next CPU burst is going to be. So the way that we're going to do that is using exponential averaging. We're going to calculate the estimate for the next CPU burst by adding together some percentage of the most recent actual CPU burst and then some percentage of our most recent guess. So in this case, we are using alpha to represent what percentage or weight we are taking from the actual length, and then we'll take the rest of it from the predicted value. This value for alpha has to be between 0 and 1. If alpha is 1, we are taking the entirety of our estimate from the most recent CPU burst, which is going to result in a rather jerky set of expectations. If the value of alpha is 0, then our guess is never going to change. It's going to be the same, but for every single CPU burst that we see from that process. So here's an example where we're predicting the length of the next CPU burst. We're using a value of alpha that's 0.5 here. So if we estimate that our first guess is going to be 10, then we will perhaps see that our first CPU burst is actually 6. So we are using the 10 and the 6 averaged together to get the 8. Then we're going to predict the value of the next CPU burst using the 8 and the 4 to get 6. Now, if our guess is the same as our previous CPU burst, we think that's pretty good and we will keep that number. But when we have the next CPU burst actually show up as 4, we then average those values together in order to get a guess of 5. So just a couple of notes about the value of alpha. If alpha is 0, then we are saying that our guess is never going to change. It's going to be the same forever. Similarly, if alpha is 1, our previous guesses do not matter, and we are taking our estimate directly from the most recent CPU burst. However, if we have a value of alpha that is between 0 and 1, not inclusive, we are going to be taking the weight of previous guesses into account. And also, we will weight the most recent CPU bursts. So, what is happening here is we are going to use alpha multiplied by our most recent CPU burst, and then we're going to multiply 1 minus alpha, and the rest of what we have here is actually an expansion of the formula. Because we have the second most recent CPU burst multiplied by alpha, and then we are adding together 1 minus alpha multiplied by the next most recent CPU burst. And eventually, we would end up back at 1 minus alpha multiplied by the original first CPU burst. So let's give this a try. I find that the easiest way to work with our CPU bursts is to have an alpha of 0.5. This shouldn't change within a specific set of calculations, but alpha can be different based on which version of this algorithm you're using or which system you're on. So, just as an example, if our actual length of the nth burst was 6 and we predicted it to be 10, then we would multiply 0.5 times 6. And then add 1 minus 0.5 multiplied by 10. So that will give us a total of 8 for our next predicted CPU burst. Let's say that CPU burst was actually 7. Now you try calculating what the next CPU burst is perhaps going to be. Pause the video here. So hopefully you got far enough that you're going to multiply 0.5 by something and then add it to 1 minus 0.5 times something. It's important to recognize which one of these is which. So the actual length of the nth burst is our t of n, and then when we have our predicted length, that is our tau of n. So we are going to be multiplying 0.5 times 7 plus 1 minus 0.5 times 8, which should give us our next predicted length of nth burst is 7.5.